What is going on, lads, and welcome back to Pokémon FIFA 14. We're on episode 2 now, and if you remember rightly, at the end of the last episode, we did manage to beat Gary and get our first evolution and get ourselves a nice rare bronze goalkeeper. We are just going to carry on with our journey and hopefully get some more evolutions on our way to an all gold, and then hopefully all in form, and then hopefully again all team of the season team. So that is what we are going to do, and if you guys want to beat me to getting them awesome teams, there's a link down in the description to the game keys where you can go and get yourself some coins. I think they're selling 100k for about £7 or £8 now, and you do get 5% off with the code AJ3 as well. So they've got some awesome Christmas deals and sales on, so go and check them out and get yourself some coins. And maybe build yourself a team and show it to me, and I might happen to use that one when I get up to the golds and awesome silvers in Pokemon FIFA. But as you can see, we are still down in the bronzes, and we've come up against an awesome Spanish bronze team. Maybe doing a bit of Pokemon FIFA himself with a couple of rares, non-rares left in. Maybe needs to get them up to rares, but all in all, it looks like an awesome team. Well built, full chemistry, and all them guys Spanish. And it does get off to an absolutely dreadful start. Same as last episode, conceding almost instantly. That guy's play there with the nice little triangle was awesome. Some dreadful defending to let him through on goal, and then a nice tidy finish into the bottom corner at the near post. It was then a bit of a quiet first half until right near the end, another bit of dreadful defending does allow him to nick the ball off us and play a nice little 1-2 to set himself through on goal, but we do manage to pull a smart save off from the goalkeeper and push it behind to give him a corner. Again, we do well to get the cleanest out, winning the header, but it does drop him on the edge of the box. He plays a nice couple of passes here to get it across the box, and then a lovely fake shot inside, you will see now, to cut into the box, play a lovely little ball, and then a lucky finish getting under the goalkeeper. We almost saved it again. I started off with a bit of dreadful defending, we did almost make up for it, but then another little bit of dreadful goalkeeping or dreadful defending from the goalkeeper does give us a 2-0 deficit at half time. So that is not what we wanted going into our second game of the series, and hopefully we can pick it back up in the second half. And that is how we start off with a lovely bit of play. We're fighting our hardest to get back into this game, and as I have been reliably informed, you pronounce this guy's name as Dusk. I think Dusk, I'm not too sure, maybe say it again, someone spell it out phonetically in the comments section. He wins us a corner, and then someone gets on the end of it, headers it onto the bar, and then there he is, Dusk, or whatever the fuck his name is, tidying up to get that goal with a nice little bicycle kick. Not that it was needed, could have just tapped it in. We're then fighting our hardest to get back into this game. It is 2-1, and we want to get that evolution. A cross into the box turns into an absolute mad scramble, and how we didn't end up someone getting on the end of this and poking it into the goal is absolutely beyond me, but we didn't quite manage it. And we were still pushing for that goal, swinging corners in, bouncing them off the bar like there's no tomorrow. How we didn't get on the end of that again to nod it into the goal, I have no idea, but we do end up losing the game 2-1. We couldn't pull it back with the equaliser, and as you can see, what does happen in Pokemon, you do white out, as it is now called. Used to black out, I think, but now we are whiting out, and we are getting sent back home to our mum's house, as we haven't really done much exploring. We are going to leg it back. We have absolutely shit ourselves, and we've run all the way home scared to our mummy. So after that dreadful start to the episode, we do get a bit of a talking to from our mum. She says that we should take a quick rest and restore our Pokemon and our own health. And that is what we do, of course. That usually happens at the Pokemon Center. We just haven't done enough exploring for that to happen yet. And she also goes on to tell us about potions, which can heal your Pokemon and stop them from blacking out. Now, what I want to know from you guys is what should happen when we get losses. We did have the question of the day last episode, which was whether you guys wanted me to show losses or not. And the general consensus was not too many, just really exciting ones. So I've put this one in. It was quite exciting, not the best of games, but I did want to get this question into you guys. What should happen when I get a loss? Should they get sent back to the Pokemon Center as you do in Pokemon when you die? You get sent all the way back and you have to work your way back to where you were on the map. Or should maybe, I've come up with the idea, and there was a couple of comments I think about this as well, that when I lose a game, one of my players will faint. So for example, if I have got a non-rare silver and I lose a game, he might faint and I'll have to pop him on the bench and use the rare bronze, that I was using beforehand. I personally think this is a better idea, and I can maybe use a potion on him to bring him back. Or I could even go to the Pokemon Center and heal up all of them if I have had a couple of losses and dropped out a few players. Like I said, I think the second option is better, and just quickly you can see we are coming into this game against an English team. He's got some silvers in there, so it is a really good team, and we're going to do well to beat this guy. I think the better option is the one where we just faint one player, especially if, say, I was in Mount Moon. Absolutely insane goal there, just going to have to stop and say what an absolutely quality finish and turn inside that was. Like I was saying, I personally think the better option is to just faint one player and use a lower rated card until we can get a potion on him, or until we can get to the Pokemon Center and heal him up. You can see we are going into halftime at 1-0 up, and I really want to know what you guys think about that question as well. So drop down in the comments section whether you think we should always have to go back to the Pokemon Center. Do you think we should faint one player? Do you think we should do nothing at all and just carry on as if it never happened? Or is there something else that you guys have thought of that could be cool, that could make an awesome addition to the series? I would like to know your thoughts, so drop them down in the comments section. You can see there we were absolutely inches away from going through on goal. awesome ball through. It just took a little bit too long to play it than I wanted it to, so we were unfortunately offside. But now we are going to go on an absolutely mental run. I've got no idea what this guy is doing. His name is Saar, and he is my centre-back, and he goes storming through on goal. I was expecting to bury that without realising that it was my centre-back at the time, and unfortunately it was a bit of a feeble shot, and the goalkeeper does palm it behind for a corner. And then we do step up with Stevanovic, and unfortunately nods it over the bar from that guy whose name I cannot pronounce. It was absolutely awesome striker. Like I said, if drop a comment down in the description as well about how to say his name phonetically, as it is really pissing me off. But some terrible goalkeeping from him there ends up giving the ball out to Saar, who once again is the wrong guy in the right place and can't finish it off for us with his terrible finishing that he does have for a centre-back. Again, punches it out to another guy whose name I am not even going to try and pronounce. That is a double-barreled one. And once again, pulls an awesome save from that goalkeeper. And then, as luck would have it, third time lucky, as the saying goes, Saar is on the end of the cross and this time manages to get the ball into the back of the net, this time with his head. Quality header after two absolutely dreadful finishes, and that is how the game ends up finishing. And of course, that means that we are going to be getting another evolution. And this time, it is going to be Bielé that's evolving. He's not the best of players, he's really slow to be using down that left midfield, so we are going to upgrade him into someone who is a lot better dribbling, he's a lot quicker, and hopefully is going to be a lot better for this team. Hopefully the players that we pull in are going to be better. Some of them are going to be a little bit worse just because the way EA do the game. Sometimes the non-rares are better than the rares. But I absolutely love this guy compared to him. And his name is Aiden or whatever you pronounce his name. I told you I was going to butcher so many names doing the Bundesliga. But this guy is quality. He's got like 90 agility or something like that. And he just dances in and out of defenders. And he scored a couple of awesome goals for us as well. So look out for him in future episodes. As this episode goes though, we are going to call it a day. If you could drop a like on it, if you have enjoyed it, that would be absolutely awesome. I think we hit over 1,000 likes on the first episode, so if we could do that again, that would be absolutely incredible. Hope you have enjoyed this episode, lads. If you are new, make sure you subscribe, and make sure you go back and watch episode 1 as well, if you did miss it, to find out what the hell is going on. But apart from that, lads, like I said, I hope you've enjoyed. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.